Hey guys, what's up? I'm Facing the News and we are here with Jagger TV on the central streets of London to find out some of the things that you toxic ladies do.
Darling's crazy but I love her. Crazy but I love her. She's the Harley to my joker.
Okay, so the mini toxic test. Okay. Have you ever cheated?
No.
No.
Okay. Have you ever said it's not you, it's me?
Yeah.
Why?
Actually, because it's not me.
It's not you.
Wait, that doesn't even make sense. That doesn't even make
sense. It's not. What do you say?
You, it's me.
It's not you, it's me.
Yeah, that doesn't make
saying
sense.
Saying that you're the problem, not them.
No, I've said it the other way.
Huh?
You've told them it's not me, it's you.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying.
What did they do, can I ask?
Oh.
What was it about them?
Like, he was just annoying me.
Okay, great, fair enough. Have you ever said, it's not you, it's me?
No. Not really, but maybe in an occasion when you don't want to speak to someone.
Yeah, that's how you cut them off.
Not really, but it's like that.
Have you ever said, it's not you, it's me?
Yeah. Yeah, I have.
Did you mean it?
No, but we need to go back to the first question. I never cheated. I just always thought about moving on with other people.
Hold up. Wait a minute.
Yeah, you know what? The Bible says that when you think about somebody else in that way,
yeah.
I'd count it, but yeah, yeah. Okay, do you admit when you're in the wrong?
No.
No.
Ever?
No.
Maybe sometimes, it depends on the occasion.
Okay. Do you admit when you're in the wrong? When you do find on the rare occasion that you are.
First, I'll admit it.
You admit it, yeah?
Okay, cool.
Yeah. Craziest thing you've done for a crush.
Oh, I did a love spell yesterday. I spent £300 on it. To get him to come back.
Did it work?
We'll see in the next 24 hours.
It takes 48.
20, yeah, to come back.
Okay, have you ever double backed on an ex?
Yes.
Right.
Multiple.
Why?
Why not? Live, love, laugh, guys. We only live once.
Okay. The craziest thing you've done to make someone jealous?
Oh, well, I kissed their best friend and fucking, like, got with them. But that's, like, the craziest thing I've done for them.
Oh, how did that work out? You're the good girl, I'm guessing.
Yeah.
Oh,
yes.
Okay. Oh.
Yeah, he didn't speak to me again and blocked me on Snap.
It didn't work.
Yeah.
She was like, I fucked my best friend for some like change. I don't get it. It's great though. I love the content. People actually do toxic things, but this is the point of today. Okay, what's going on? What is the craziest experience you've had with the opposite sex?
A man going to my purse and robbing me and also making me pay for his parking. He drives, but he don't have money to afford the driving, so
was this recent?
It was this year. And if you ever see this, hi.
Took money out of your purse.
Yeah.
And you
had a day.
You had to pay for
it. He took it out of my purse and then I saw it on the side and I thought, there's no way. Cool.
Yeah.
Put it back in my bag.
Yeah.
And then he must have bugged out because I guess he was on a come down. And then
what do you mean by come down?
He was on it.
On the what? This one? Okay.
Yeah,
right,
yeah.
Okay.
Oh, hell no.
So that's another debacle, how I know that.
Debacle.
But basically, he must have been like, what happened to the money on the side? And I was like, oh, I put it back in my bag because you know it's mine. He's like, oh, I need it for the parking.
Yeah.
I already paid for the parking.
Yeah.
So, yeah, he's just a crackhead.
Right, okay. And we wish him well. We wish him a speedy recovery. Thank you very much. Okay, cool. Thank you. So, the craziest experience you've had with the opposite sex?
Well, my mum is right next to me, so.
No way this is your mum.
Yeah.
I thought sisters.
Ah!
Come on, mummy. Come on.
Well, I feel like right now.
My favourite person in the whole wide world. Forever, forever,
I'm not even joking.
him.
Okay.
I feel like I'm not even in the shot no more.
I'm going to find out some toxic traits you have. So if you know yourself, what are your toxic traits in relationships? What is the craziest thing you've done for a crush?
I know I have toxic traits, but I just...
What's the toxic trait that you have then?
I can't think of any on the spot. I don't know. My head's just...
One time...
You have the craziest... Okay, there we
no,
go.
Okay, yeah. One time, I went on his Facebook. I found out his surname.
His Facebook?
Okay. Yeah. Looked for his mum, found his...
address.
No.
Address.
You found the address, did you?
You found the address.
No, but I don't know. I just snooping around, so I just looked through his family, yeah, everything. And then, yeah, that's really about it.
Okay.
Did you find his address?
Nearly. I found his school though.
Okay.
Craziest breakup.
Craziest breakup would have been, I'd woke up one day with a boy that I'd been with 4 years, didn't think he was going to do it with me, and then I just woke up and was like, that's it, you've got to move out. Craziest breakup. I don't even know why. I'm a delight.
Did you ask it? I would have been like, why?
Look at me, I'm a delight. Like, why?
Did you ask him why?
Yeah, or I did. He said he didn't know, so.
And you left?
No, I just left, because it was just easier than the rows.
You wasn't really feeling it, was you?
No, and I can imagine it's not good for your story, is it?
No, it's great. I want truth. I want authenticity so that people know that there are toxic men out there as well.
Craziest date.
The craziest date. I've never really had crazy dates, you know. Okay. Actually, no. Yes, I have.
Yeah.
I think this was more of a lowdown. I think it was.
What's a lowdown?
Like a lowdown, like it was like it was me and my ex anniversary. And he took me to the chicken shop for our anniversary.
Nando's, yeah.
Not even Nando's, just a normal chicken.
What? What is that? What? What do people do that?
Yeah, people actually do that. Normal chicken shop, and he promised
for our anniversary. He proposed in there.
Take us out, we'll go out next week or something.
What happened next week?
Next week, yeah. Nothing happened. Literally.
So you stayed with him throughout 2 weeks?
We stayed with him for even longer than years.
Mm-hmm.
He was there. But
that's no more.
There's more, but you know.
You know, there's nothing.
Look, no,
there's nothing wrong with the chicken shop, no, you know. There's nothing wrong.
It's a normal, as in chicken and chips, yeah. Like they fry it in 5 minutes.
Yeah.
That's where we spent the anniversary, yeah, there.
But was the conversation deep?
The conversation was, look how we spent our anniversary. Wow. Like, up time has come to soon.
Oh, so you didn't speak at that time. No. Why did you stay? What was it, can I ask?
No, like, I don't even know. Do you know when you're just... foolish, you're just, yeah. Common sense ain't coming.
Okay.
Yeah, like it's not.
Yeah. 2022, we're doing much better though. Absolutely. Even right now, even tomorrow.
Yeah.
Even okay, tomorrow. Yeah, it's in the past. I like that. Due to censorship. Censorship. Censorship laws. We cannot, because let's say you're underage, but there is a very toxic story to my right. And it goes like this.
So I was dating a man from Surrey and he was more of an influencing type, and he...
Like an influencer on Instagram?
Yes. For a certain fashion community, very big one.
Nike.
Yes, and everything. Oh my.
Nike.
Sorry. Just saying, like a Dunkanery. But anyway, we were in a relationship, very twisted. He pursued me when I was quite young and he's older than me.
How much?
So... between me, I was like 15, 16, but he was like 24, 25. We were in a relationship, I put that in quotation.
Yeah.
And then one day I left his house to go home because that weekend was very weird. We made plans, but he wasn't trying to go out and he was always on his phone.
How far in the relationship were you at this point?
Like, I was at his family's house all the time, every weekend. And then he acted really weird, left. Next day went to work, got a message from a friend saying to me he's been arrested. Don't know how my friend knew, couldn't tell my friend my business. But he was like, oh, did you hear this person got arrested? I was like,
are you the friend?
No. And I was told that he got arrested because two girls that he was, one of them he was allegedly dating and her sister, went down to a certain location in the country to go and thing him out because they found out that he was dating other girls. 20 minutes later, I was put into a group chat with over 104 women.
Whoa.
Because out of all of them, 19 of us he was in a relationship with.
Whoa!
7 of us he was trying to get pregnant all at the same time.
Damn!
Then the whole chat was copied and pasted. So he put the same picture like, oh, I want my girl, my child to look like this, I want my child to look like that, da 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 da, all of this stuff. And then
I'm confused. Right.
Job as a way to lure girls in, so he got progressive conduct. And apparently. That when like I leave my products, so like my hair sheen and all, like my Cantu's bad for you black girls, please don't you?
Yeah, it.
He would put it in a dog, like in a bag, and put my name on it because he had like OCD, and like he put it under the bed and like in a box, and like all the girls' stuff would be organized, and then when you come, he'd take it out. So as I would leave, a girl would be on her way, and as I was coming, a girl would have just left.
That's some Joe stuff. You watch you. That is Joe. No, his name was Joe.
Joe. Give me a damn Joe. I love that. I'm crazy.
He had doggy bags and it would have your name. When the next Clarissa comes, he would take out Clarissa's stuff. Wow, thank you so much. I wish nothing but healing for you and a very prosperous.
Yeah,
amen. Yeah, that was a lot. That was deep. That was deep. Like, that is the craziest breakup. Imagine man having a doggy bag with your name on it. And then, I couldn't get Clarissa out of my, it was not rolling off the tongue. When Clarissa comes, he's got Clarissa's bag, takes it out, lays out everything. That is mad! That is toxic.
I'm a Leo.
Do they have toxic traits?
Yeah, I'm not gonna lie, you.
What are they?
Like, we're very self-centered, kind of.
Main personality syndrome.
Or something like that.
Main character.
Yeah. You got that?
Me, always.
Okay, I got that, okay.
So that means you've had the craziest experience with the opposite sex. That's main character.
What do you class as a crazy experience?
Like, something where you're like, whoa, that's toxic, or what the hell just happened? Or when you realise this person hates me.
They never hate me, the other one. I think there's one thing, but this is me, like.
Okay, you tell me, and if it's not, we just won't put it in.
I'll just be leaving crystals in the house, like, to manifest them.
You'll be leaving crystals to manifest them.
Like, this is like, let's say we're not together yet, like a couple dates, but I'm like in love with them. I need crystals.
What did the crystals do?
For example, this one is rose
water. To attract love. Is that why we're here
today? Oh, self-love. Yeah, and any kind of love.
Crazy, but the love.